Hi and welcome you all. I am Akansha. In the today's video, I will go to explain one of the most important topic from an organic chemistry, that is the selectivity in the organic reaction. This topic is very important to solve the any kind of the reaction in an organic chemistry. In this video, I will explain the basic approach toward the selectivity, that is what are the types of selectivity and what is mean by the selectivity. You might be wondering that what is mean by the selectivity. Before moving towards the actual topic, we will understand what does the word selectivity means. To make more clear about selectivity, we will take one example. Okay. We will consider a one example, that is the drug interaction with the cell. When a drug molecule releases into the body, its first role is that it must target to the specific cell, tissue or organ selectively. Mark my word, I had said here selectively. The drug which is get released in the body should only act on the cells which are affected by the disease, not other cells which are normal. The drug targeting refers to the targeting of a drug to the specific cell out of a numerous cell. This is how the drug targets specifically, what we call as an selectively. I hope from this example, you might get some idea regarding the word, that is a selectivity. Now moving toward the topic, that is a selectivity in the organic reaction. The selectivity in the organic reaction is a very increasingly important part of any organic synthesis. The whole basis of organic chemistry and especially the organic synthesis depend upon the selectivity which can be achieved in the organic reaction. The selectivity of the reaction is a most important concept that basically define how and what the product are formed. The problem of selectivity comes when an organic molecule have more than a one functional group. If an organic molecule have more than a one functional group, basically three questions comes in mind, that which functional group will react, in case of reagent where it will react and how it will react. Okay. These three are the top question comes in a mind whenever we see the reactant having the more than the one functional group. So the answer to this all three questions is given by the selectivity. The first selectivity, that is answer to the first question, that is a which functional group will react, is given by the chemoselectivity. The chemoselectivity refers to which functional group will react. In the chemoselectivity, the reagent chooses on which functional group it should react. Now we will understand the chemoselectivity by seeing the one of the example. Okay. To understand the concept of the chemoselectivity or to know what is mean by the chemoselectivity, we will consider here the one example. That is, this is a 4-amino phenol. It consists of the two functional group, that is NH2 and OH. In the presence of excess of acetic anhydride, both the functional groups are get acylated. But what if when there is only the one equivalent of the acetic anhydride? In such case, the reagent has to be very choosy, and the reagent need to be choose any of the one functional group from this, that is either OH or other NH2, to form the acylated product. In such case, we know that the amines are more nucleophilic than alcohol, so this acetic anhydride acylates the amine functional group rather than the OH, and we get the paracetamol as a product. And in a second case, you can see this both acylated product when get hydrolyzed by using the NaOH, then we know that esters are more reactive than the amide, so esters will get hydrolyzed easily as compared to amide, and we get a paracetamol as a product. In these example, we clearly came to know that how reagent choose what product it should form. this is nothing but this is a chemoselectivity. That is how chemoselectively the reagent choose where it have to react on which functional group. This chemoselectivity gives the answer to the question, that is which functional group will react. In this case, two functional groups were there, that is first were OH and second was an NH, but this acetic anhydride chooses NH2. Why? Because it is more nucleophilic, and here NaOH chooses ester. Why? Because it is more reactive to form the paracetamol. This is a famous example to understand what is mean by the chemoselectivity. Okay, now moving towards the next point. Now let us remind our second question. Our second question was where to react. The answer to this question is given by the regioselectivity. The regioselectivity occurs in the chemical reaction where the one reaction site is preferred over another. The regioselective reaction are the reaction that take place to produce two or more product and the one of the product predominate. To understand the regioselectivity, we will again consider one example for making more clear what is mean by the regioselectivity, that is where to react. For understanding the concept of the regioselectivity, consider the example, that is addition of the HBr to the alkene. In this case, the HX is added to this alkene, we get a two product. Okay, we will consider one example, that is addition of the HBr to the alkene. In the first case, we are getting the primary carbocation, and in a second case, we are getting the secondary carbocation, which get further attacked by the Br minus. In this case, we will get a two different product, that is first product will form by the primary carbocation and the second product will form by the secondary carbocation. We know that the primary carbocation are less stable, so this generally this route is not favored, or we will get this product as a minor product, and the product which is formed by the secondary carbocation will be the major product over here. So in this case, if we get a two product, one product will be the major, that will predominate over the other. This is a regioselective reaction. The second example which we can consider, that is an attack of nucleophile on an epoxide. That is, this nucleophile can attack from the hindered phase or the less hindered phase. Actually, in such condition, the reaction condition affects such kind of the reaction, and we will get a two kind of the product over here, which is formed by the attack of the nucleophile on the epoxide. Again, this is an example of the regioselective reaction. In short, we can say that the regioselectivity simply implies that there is a one functional group that can react in a two different place, and reagent must choose where it have to react. Now, the problem of which functional group will react and where it will react is solved. Now, the third question comes, that is how it will react. To answer this question is given by stereoselectivity. The stereoselective reaction is a reaction in which one stereoisomers predominate over the another. Such reaction where a one stereoisomers of the product is formed predominantly because the reaction has a choice of pathway and one pathway is more favorable than other. Such reaction are called as stereoselective reaction. If the product of these stereoselective reaction are both the enantiomers, that are the non-superimposable mirror image of each other, in such case, such reactions are said to be enantioselective reaction. And if the product are the two diastereomers, that is opposite to enantiomers, then such a reaction is said to be the diastereoselective reaction. This we can say the stereoselectivity is basically dominated by the structural features of the reactant. That is, the structural features of the reactant determine understanding the concept of the stereoselectivity. We will consider one example, that is this attack of the nucleophile on the tertiary butyl cyclohexanone. Here, the nucleophile can attack axially or it can attack equatorially, and we will get this product. But the axial product The equatorial product will be predominant only when, the cases are given over here, when the larger nucleophile is there, then we get the equatorial product as a major product. And if in the second case, if the smaller nucleophiles are there, then we will get the axial product as a major product. Okay, this is a stereoselectivity, that is from where that a nucleophile should attack, that is either axial attack or either equatorial attack, that is attack of nucleophile in the space, that is how should be the attack of nucleophile in the space, either axial or equatorial. This is how we define the stereoselectivity by considering this example. This is a best example you can consider for explaining the stereoselectivity, that is axial or equatorial attack on the cyclohexanone. This is an example. See here, again I will repeat it. Whenever there is a large nucleophile, then equatorial attack product which is formed will be the major product. It means that this product will be the major product. And when there are the small nucleophile, then axial product will be the major product. The various reasons are there due to steric hindrance and etc. We will not see it. We will just focus on the what is mean by the stereoselectivity. Now this is another example, that is a stereoselective reaction, that is an epoxidation. Here the major stereoisomer will be formed by the attack on the sterically less hindered phase. This will be the major product and this is will be the minor product. These both are the stereoisomers or each other. So this is reaction is known as a stereoselective reaction. Now I hope you are get with the all three selectivity, that is a chemoselectivity, radioselectivity and the stereoselectivity, and what is actually mean. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Like, share and subscribe my channel, that is a Chem Magic by me. If you want to learn more detail about this topic, I must refer you book, that is an Organic Chemistry by Cladden. In this book a detailed information is given, so try to go through it.